to kiss a lovely girl. But I messed it up under the influence of my friends. Contest chair, panel of judges, fellow Toastmasters and guests, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
It was the annual school celebrations, and I was the Prince Charming. To kiss the sleeping beauty and bring her back to life. I was 6 years old and had no clue why the teacher chose me for such an act. Maybe my extremely good looks, the curse that I suffered to be. I was frightened of the stage, and kissing was not tempting like a lollipop. The children in my class, they were dead against the idea of kissing. They said, it's not cool for a boy to kiss a girl. Toastmasters, remember, I was only 6 years old. They even warned me about the side effects of kissing, and that I may end in hell. I was dragged on to the rehearsal stage, like an animal being led into the slaughterhouse. Trembling with fear, reluctantly I stood at the edge of the stage, and then all went blank, like what happens when you get a table topics. I fell off from the stage, broke my arm. The role of the Prince Charming was taken away. I was happy and relieved. My friends believed they had influenced me and saved me from burning in hell. At a later stage, in college, new friends, new interests. To play the Prince Charming was one. But the college did not stage any such dramas. I decided to venture on my own. The prospects were plenty and promising. When there is plenty, I have a problem. I get confused. My grandma's advice came to my rescue. Son, one at a time. But none of these beauties volunteered, and all the prospects remained promising and answering. I patiently persevered, encouraged by the words, when one door shuts, knock on the other. I tapped. I knocked. I even pounded on doors, but to no effect. One evening, it was raining heavily, and I was walking through the corridors of the college, the empty corridors of the college. And then I see this beauty standing by the chemistry lab, waiting for the downpour to end. Fortunately, I had an umbrella. I sensed a chemistry in there. Not bothered about the reaction, I offered her a lift in my humble umbrella. Seeing it was getting late and dark, she accepted the offer. I thanked my mother, who insisted on carrying the umbrella. My friends for having left me alone for once. I thanked nature and prayed the rains would continue. While unfolding the umbrella, I silently chanted a few mantras. I held the umbrella with reverence and wished I had carried a swallow. She was carrying a large record book. Luckily, it did not record my feelings, but acted as a barrier between us. This was my closest encounter as we walked side by side, accommodating each other. My heart was pounding. My mind was running wild like a headless chicken. And then, as an act of God, the lightning struck. She tried to grab the umbrella, instead held my hand. The mantra was working. Nature had set the stage, the spotlight was on. Music followed with the rumbling in the sky of the thunder roaring. Even time stood still. This beautiful moment. The moment I desired. But then I heard my grandmother whispering in my ears, "Prince Charming, don't take advantage of the situation." I brought her home and she thanked me. And very soon I got the tag of nice girl. Thereafter, I always carried a number now. You never know when you need it. But this time, a smaller one. But to no luck. Even the dark clouds ran away. Years later, I moved to the Middle East. Another beautiful place. Prospects were good, excellent, promising. But I refrained from it. Because I found playing the Prince Charming here was very risky. Laws were strict. And the punishment very severe. I secretly nursed the desire. And marriage was my last and desperate resort to play the role. During my brief courtship, I exaggerated the role of the Prince Charming to impress my future wife, Pavitra. The days that followed our marriage, she stamped her influence on my rule, and I became a Prince Charming at her beck and call. But how long can I play the Prince Charming to the same girl? So Toastmasters, if by any chance you're planning a romantic drama like the Sleeping Beauty, or for that matter any beauty, I'm willing to play the role.